Today we'll be talking about monetary policy. There are two types of policies that follow under this, which are contractionary policy and expansionary policy. Contractionary policy is known as tight money policy. Selling securities, increasing the reserve ratio, and raising the discount rate are actions called tight money policy. The objective is to gain tightened money supply in order to reduce spending and control inflation. Expansionary policy is also known as easy money policy. It is buying securities, lowering the reserve ratio, and lowering the discount rate are actions called an easy money policy. The point is to make both bank loans less expensive and more available, which will increase AD output and employment.
Reserve requirement. This is the set minimum percentage of its checkable deposit that a bank must keep on deposit that a federal bank will hold as all cash. Define RR. You multiply the reserve ratio by the checkable deposits. Excess reserves. The bank's actual reserves exceeds its required reserves. You find this by doing actual reserves minus required reserves. Checkable deposits. Any deposit that a commercial bank or that an institution where a check may be written. This consists of more than half of the M1 money. Money supply. There are three money definitions. They consist of M1, M2, and M3 money. M1 is currency in the hands of the public, such as cash or checkable deposits. M2 is saving deposits, including money market deposits accounts such as small-time deposits and money market mutual funds. M3 includes large-time deposits. M3 equals to M2 plus large deposits. The difference between fiscal policy and monetary policy. Fiscal policy decisions are determined by the Congress, while monetary policy decisions are made by the individual agencies of the federal government, referred as the Federal Reserve. Federal fund rate. The interest rate that the Fed charged one another on overnight loans that made out of their own excess reserves. This tool allows them, the Federal Reserve, to affect the spending decisions of households. In this banking problem, the scenario is the Federal Reserve buys $5,000 in bonds from a yellow consulting firm, which then deposits the money in a checking account at Wachovia Bank. In question A, it says, as a result of the Federal Reserve's action, what is the change in the money supply if the required reserves ratio is 100%? So basically saying that the required reserve is 100%, so they have to keep 100% of the check on the demand deposit, which is $5,000. So there is no change. Which basically means is that since they have to hold all of their RR, there is no ER, therefore they cannot create any new money supply. The reserve ratio is reduced to 10%. Calculate the following. Number one, the maximum amount this bank can lend up from this deposit. So what would you do is you multiply your new reserve ratio to your demand deposit, which is 5,000. So it would be 5,000 times 0.10, and that should give you 500. And then you would subtract the 500 from your demand deposit, which would be 5,000 minus 500, and it would give you your answer, which is 4,500. Number two, the maximum increase in the total money supply from the Federal Reserve purchase in bonds. So what would you do is you would multiply your demand deposit, which is 5,000, times 1 over 0.10, which is 10, and that should give you $50,000, which is your answer. And C, if banks keep some of the deposits as excess reserves, how would this influence the change in the money supply that was determined in your part B and 2 exponent? So it will decrease the money supply. And because it's being decreased, the reason why is because you're not using all your reserves, your excess reserves, therefore you're not making new loans, and you're decreasing your maximum multiplier. And C,
If banks keep some of the deposits as excess reserves, how would this influence the change in the money supply that was determined in your part B and to explain? So it will decrease the money supply. And because it's being decreased, the reason why is because you're not using all your reserve money, your excess reserves, therefore you're not making new loans, and you're decreasing your maximum. If the public decides to hold some money in the form of currency rather than in demand deposits, how will this influence the change in the money supply that was determined in B2? There will be no change. And the reason for that is because the currency is already part of the money supply. And if it's not in the form of demand deposits, you can't loan out those money, that reserve to create new loans. Therefore, the money supply cannot increase.